In the studio with me now is Lithium Energy's General Manager of Projects, Graham Fyfe. Graham, thanks for joining us today.
Hi, Jonathan. Thanks for having me on. I'm excited to be here.
It's a pleasure. Now, you've confirmed outstanding test work results from spherical purified graphite produced from the Burke Graphite Project. Can you take us through the work that's being done there?
Yeah, as we previously announced, we had produced good quality spherical graphite, four different sizes, and we purified it up to 99.97% total graphitic carbon. Some of that material was sent off to an institutional battery tester in Germany by ProGraphite, who did our work. And they've actually basically made an anode out of our graphite, an uncoated purified spherical graphite anode, and then did charge testing on our battery and looked at the stability of it and whether the graphite degrades under high multiple charging cycles and so on. And they've come back with some really great results showing our natural graphite can hold good specific charge capacities of 364 milliamp hour per gram, which when the theoretical capacity of natural graphite charging capability is 372 milliamp hour per gram, it shows really, really good results. And I think one of the other key things to note is that the graphite didn't degrade or get damaged during the charging and discharging processes, meaning it's really suitable for anode material.
So, Graham, can you talk us through how significant these results are based on what you've just said here?
Well, not all graphite's equal, and all graphite will hold a charge, but to what extent? And obviously, with the movement in the battery markets, everyone trying to reduce costs, the higher the charge you can hold, the more powerful the battery, the longer the life, and so on. So having a graphite that holds a really good charge in an uncoated form is really exciting for us and probably the key piece in our puzzle overall to show that the Burke graphite is exceptional in the anode market.
Talking about the puzzle here, can you give us an indication of what this puzzle is and what it means for the company to actually find that final piece?
Yeah, look, graphite is a tricky one, but it's relatively simple to get up to its purified state. You know, mining it and floating it, it's relatively easy. And most graphites will get to a decent concentrate out of the mine. Then you shape it, which is a mechanical process, so you can shape anything. It comes down to what your recoveries and losses are and so on. And then purifying it is typically a chemical process to get rid of the deleterious elements that are sitting in and on the graphite flakes. So getting to that point is a process, and each graphite is slightly different, so it'll come down to operating costs and steps. But the charge capacity of your graphite is the key thing for the battery. I guess in many respects, it's like different things in iron ore. The lower the grade, the higher the deleterious elements, and so on, has different impacts on your final product. Well, the charge capacity is the final step. If we had a really low charge capacity, even though we could make great spherical purified graphite, it may not be enticing to the market because the batteries would really struggle to keep and get to charge. But we have a very high specific charge capacity. So that is the final piece of that whole, I guess, anode material sort of puzzle, the BAM puzzle, as it were. And that's why we're very excited.
So the next step now is to optimize the BAM development pathway. How will you go about doing that?
So what we'll be looking at in through the course of this year is to continue the technical work that we started last year and pull together, I guess, the overall capex and optics of the actual entire operating process from mine to SPG. But at the same time, with graphite, which is not like some of the other battery metals and minerals, there's quite a lengthy validation process for the customers to be certain your product is suitable for batteries, it doesn't cause problems, won't degrade. So we have planned to build a pilot plant. And in that pilot plant, we will process and optimize the whole process to produce the spherical purified graphite, and then use that material to secure binding offtake agreements as opposed to non-binding offtake agreements. We expect to get that plant, with all things going well, up and running by the end of the year. and producing material that we can actually show the market, and also taking information from the pilot plant back into our DFSs and later studies as we move towards the detailed design and production pathway.
And just in between all of this happening, what can investors expect over the next couple of months?
So over the next few months, we'll be looking at really kicking off and getting things moving. We've got to design the pilot plant first. We have all the information we need to start looking at that. So that'll be one of the key things we look at over the next few months, is designing it, getting the equipment ordered, securing space in Townsville and Queensland, who are very supportive for this kind of thing. They have some demonstration plants for vanadium there. So it's a very supportive environment. So I'll be looking at pushing all that through to make sure we don't have any real problems once the equipment hits the ground and we pull a bulk sample out of Burke and get things going.
Graham, sounds like it's a lot of work ahead, but thanks for your time.
It's only a pleasure. Thanks, Jonathan.